Hello people, welcome to this video dedicated to Pinnacle Studio 18. Leave us comments to improve our videos. Pinnacle Studio 18 is a great video editing software used to create your own video projects and slideshows. We will see in this video how to use it and its main important features. Above, you have three different workspaces: Organize, Edit and Offer. Organize is used to manage all that you have in Pinnacle: media, so your files under a blue color, effects, transitions and all Pinnacle content indicated in yellow, groups of files called collections under a green color, and all your projects made with Pinnacle under a violet color. Edit is the main workspace to create your video. We will see it later. Offer is used to create discs and DVDs. We will see this in a future video. All the main features of this software are inside the Edit workspace. On top and on the left, you have the navigation panel that collects default sample media files, media you imported, and all effects and transitions ready to use. This is simply like the Organize workspace. In fact, if you hover the pin button in the top left corner, you will find the same menu met in Organize. You can check its content better using the zoom bar in the bottom right corner. More on the right, you have the preview to check your project or the files in the navigation panel. If you select a media file there, you can use the preview player to check it. At the bottom, you have the timeline where you will work on your video. In between, you have some quick buttons we will see during this full guide. First of all, you need to import your files on your project. To start a new project, just go to File, New, and then to Movie. Then click on Import above the preview. The Studio Importer window appears. Choose on the left where to import from. You can import from a cam, import from a disk, or from your computer. In this case, check all files you want to import. Then go to Start Import below. Use Check and Uncheck All to select faster. Files imported are inside a temporary collection called Latest Import. In the future, you can find these imported files inside Media, checking in the list. Each group of files is defined by their location, indicated on top. It may be useful to create your own collection of media files, for example for the project you are going to build. Simply select all files holding Ctrl down, right click and go to Add to Collection and create a new one. Just when files are inside the navigation panel, you can add them in your project. Simply click and drag files on the main timeline below. If you need more sample audio files, you can try Score Fitter, clicking on the Create Song button. Try it out. If you need to record from outside, just click on VoiceOver. All files inside your timeline are called clips. You can have four kinds of them: image clips, video clips, sound clips and text clips. If you want to know how to add and manage text in Pinnacle Studio 18, watch the related video in this guide. Each clip is shown with its thumbnail and its sound waveform, more below. Of course, photos won't have any sound waveform and music won't have any thumbnail. Plus, each has its own color, depending on its kind. Text clips are under a green color, image clips are dark blue, videos in blue color and sound clips in yellow. All of them are inside rows called audio-video tracks. You can manage these very easily. The eye and the loudspeaker icons are used to hide or mute the track, which means to disable visible frames or sound of all clips inside such track. If you click on the lock icon instead, you will lock the track. You will still hear and watch its clips, but you can't modify any of them until you unlock the track again. If you right-click on a track, you can rename, delete such track, or add new ones. You can zoom in and out, holding Ctrl down and using your mouse wheel. If you use your mouse wheel while holding Alt down, you can move vertically to check each of your AV tracks. Let's see how to work with your clips. You can move a selected clip simply dragging it. Your pointer will turn to a white hand. You can also move on another track. If you hold the Ctrl down, you can select more clips to move them all together. You can stretch or shorten clips, dragging their edges from the internal side. In case you stretch videos and audio clips with a fixed duration in time, you will simply add blank parts inside, muted and with black frames, showing red in your timeline. You can apply crossfade transitions, dragging from the top corners of the clip. These are used to make a clip appear and disappear. If you want to know how to apply transitions, check the related video in this guide. When you stretch or apply transitions in this way, make sure to drag from the clip itself. If you stretch with the arrow in the opposite direction, you will simply edit the time interval between the interested clip and the following one. You can cut, copy, paste, and delete clips, right-clicking on them. To split a clip in two instead, place the red playhead, dragging it and press the N letter from your keyboard, or click on the Split Clips button on top. To undo any mistaken action, just press Ctrl and Z. To go backwards or onwards with your actions, use the Undo and Redo buttons in the top left corner. It is very important the tracks order. If clips do overlap in time on different tracks, the preview shows the clips that stay on the upper track. To move tracks up and down, simply click and drag them on the left. While you work on your project, check the preview often. The preview has a source and a timeline mode. When source is on, the preview shows the media files selected from the navigation panel. But if you are in the timeline mode, the preview shows your project in progress in the timeline, where the playhead is placed. Just click and drag above the timeline to drag it. And, if you want to be more precise, just use your mouse wheel. Use a space key to play and stop fast. Also, the player below the preview has a playhead you can drag. You can also change the playing speed and make the selected clip played in loop, enabling loop play. You can also play in full screen, clicking on the top right corner. Use Escape key to exit. Clips just added in the timeline may show a rendering bar on top. Wait for it in order to have a fluid preview of it. Important is also to track the audio volume. Below all, on the left, you have a dB meter. Make sure this never gets red during all your project, or you risk distortion. In case you need to adjust the volume, click on the first icon on top. This shows local dB meters for each single track, and a knob to regulate the volume. You have other important buttons above the tracks list. Click on Timeline Settings to set the general settings of your project, preview included. Check out our following video to know how to apply HD settings to your video. The next button lets you check your projects with storyboards or with the navigator, very useful in complex projects with lots of clips inside. The navigator shows you the overall project with all its clips inside, using their same background color. The transparent rectangle is right what you are seeing in the timeline. If you move or stretch it, the timeline follows. Once your project is done, save it. Go to Save and then to Save Movie As. Pinnacle video projects are saved as movie.axp files and can be opened later if you want to make changes. But if you want to export your video, you must render it. Go to Export button above the preview. Studio Exporter lets you export your video as you like. You have lots of ways to export. File to save the video in your computer. Disk to burn all inside a DVD. Cloud to send it to social websites. And device to export for consoles. In each of these, check out the settings at the bottom and all details. On the right, you can also check the size amount required and change the destination folder clicking on the folder icon. Fix the orange markers to decide which part of the project to render. When you are done, just click on Start below All. Thanks for watching. Go on with our following videos to discover more inside Pinnacle Studio 18.